What's the difference between memory and disk space? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. I want to address what turns out to be a very common confusion that unfortunately can cause things like questions to go misunderstood, answers to be inappropriate, just because when we think we're talking about one thing, and yet the terminology we're using talks about something else, it's very easy to get confused. And one of those places where things get confused a lot is this concept of memory. Memory has a very specific definition in the tech world. And unfortunately, I see folks using it for other things. So let's go through the kinds of things that we might consider to be memory, because they all remember things of some sort. And then we'll talk about exactly what it is that the word memory refers to. First up, RAM, random access memory. These are circuit boards you will probably find inside of your computer, be it a desktop or a laptop, and honestly, your mobile device has RAM as well. But the bottom line here is that RAM is the memory that's holding your running programs, the data that you're operating on, the operating system, again, while it's running. The key takeaway for RAM is that when you turn off the power, RAM loses everything inside. In fact, when you put your laptop, say, in standby, one of the characteristics of standby is that it shuts down a lot of the hardware to save power, but it keeps power turned on to RAM so that RAM continues to remember whatever is in it as long as your computer is in standby. Now, disk, let's talk about disk. And for this discussion, I'm actually talking about both hard disks, spinning metal platter hard disks, and solid state drives. SSDs are typically used now in place of, or in addition to, more traditional hard drives because they're smaller, faster, use less power, the whole idea. But the important thing about both of them is that information is written to them, is saved to them. So when you do like a file save of a document, you are saving it to disk. The characteristic that differentiates disk is that when you remove the power, the disk remembers everything anyway. In the case of a spinning metal platter disk, it's actually saved magnetically. In the case of an SSD, it's actually saved electronically through the magic of some flash memory circuits. But the key there is that it's saved. Now, there is another kind of disk that I at least have to mention, and these are flash drives. Remember that I said SSDs use the magic of flash memory. So do thumb drives, so do flash drives, but they use a typically much less expensive flash memory that basically doesn't last as long. But the concept is still the same. You use them like a disk because when you unplug them, they remember whatever was on them. So basically, we have two characteristics of things. We have RAM, the memory in your computer that basically is used while your machine is running, that goes away when you remove power, and disks, hard disks, SSDs, flash drives. They all remember what is written to them even when the power is removed. Memory, even though all of the things that we've just talked about can be considered to have or be a form of memory because they remember things, memory refers exclusively to RAM. So when you tell me that you have 2 terabytes of memory, that today isn't happening. You're not talking about RAM. 2 terabytes these days are the size of disks. You have 2 terabytes of disk space. If you're talking about your RAM, the numbers are typically smaller. 16 gigabytes, 32 gigabytes, that kind of thing. Where it can get confusing, of course, is that those are also common sizes for thumb drives. But the bottom line here is that we really, really need to clarify that when we're talking about memory, we are talking about the RAM that is installed in your computer that is being used only when the computer is actually running. Everything else is disk space in one form or another. As you can see, if somebody comes to me with a problem that they claim is memory that turns out to be disk space, I may be thinking down the wrong path. I may give them bad answers. So once again, this is a case where the difference matters. The terminology matters for clarity. And honestly, even when you go to buy a new computer, understanding how much RAM you're getting and how much disk space you're getting is also very important. So, a couple of terms that are worth understanding the difference between: memory and disk space. And now hopefully you do. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/4727. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.